I think it's sick because he's making them, he could have promoted it from a point of view that's not boxing, but getting their licenses, no head guard, rounds of boxing. What people have to realise is you have to put all eyes on boxing, us all to fight. So KSI and Logan Paul have got a bigger following than me and most of the heavyweights on this table combined. So if all those eyes are going to now watch me and watch my competitors and watch the sport of boxing is going to rise, I always say I'm for it. So good luck to them both. I hope they take it serious because they can earn some respect here. People look at them like a joke now and they doubt them. But if they take it serious and they put on a good performance, people might scratch their head and say, hang on a minute, you know, this wasn't such a bad idea. And then you never know. YouTubers or this type of event might happen more often, then it gives you another platform to cover as well.
Thanks, guys. You really got a wrap.
Thank you, man.
Yeah. Come back to America.
Your schedule ever? You don't think about the zones, so you just keep going, and you never think about what time zone you're in, and it doesn't really affect you. The worst thing you can do is sit down and say, "What time is it where I was?" It doesn't matter, you just got to work and sleep. Get your sleep when you can. I slept for 7 hours on the plane. Joshua slept for 12 hours on the plane from Saudi Arabia. It was the most mind-blowing experience I've ever had in boxing. It was crazy.
Didn't take Bob's edibles?
No, I like the interview. It's not really my thing, but I think the way he's going at 87, I think I need to get on the edibles. I don't even know what they are, but they sound great.
Eddie, who has more pressure to win this?
Do you know, the press conference yesterday was so fascinating because both guys, I felt, looked a little bit nervy in it. I mean, don't forget, yesterday we were in a country that neither men had been before, you know, never staged a mega fight. I mean, it was just the most remarkable thing I've ever seen. And both guys, I think they were a little bit nervous, whether they admit it or not, because it was a whole new experience. And, you know, Ruiz had a little air of, not arrogance, but confidence about him. Joshua reminded me of a little bit how he reminded me in the early days, you know, just a little bit more edgy than he used to be. It had a lot more edge than the first press conference because the first press conference had no edge. I mean, he gave him his belts, you know, and Ruiz looked like a competition winner. And yesterday, you know, Ruiz travelled, looked, behaved like a champion. And I think Joshua, again, whether he admits it or not, wants this challenger mentality in this fight. In terms of who's got more pressure, well, I don't know. I mean, for Joshua, it's a must-win fight. For Ruiz, you know, I don't know whether the mentality, you know, he's obviously got a huge amount of money over two fights. Does that take the edge off? Does that take the hunger off? Or does that drive him on to want more and to be in bigger fights? Because if Ruiz wins this fight, he's the biggest star in boxing. You know, and if Joshua wins the fight, he probably is. And then, you know, you start talking about the fights that we talked about, you know, non-stop for 18 months.
Mm-hmm. As they,
Elie Seckbach.